Shut your FX off, too.
All right. Now we're live. After the first time in 6 weeks, we come on, and then I get a call that our bantering was heard on the live, as we're pretty stressed out here, trying to get a show done. Well, we haven't set up in 6 weeks, and not quite sure what was happening, so we apologize for any bantering that was heard. In any case, it is what it is. So we are live here on Sunday night after many, many weeks being off. And we were off for personal reasons, for an illness in my family. And finally on Tuesday, July 6th, after what was, I'd say, a short battle, my mom passed away. Elizabeth Ann Dumville, farmer's daughter, country girl from Florence Point. Born on February 21st, 1946. And it's been a struggle in the last little while. I'll tell you a little bit about the story. Why not? About 6-7 weeks ago, I got a call from a friend of my mother's, and it was a call I don't usually take from this person, and it said, she said that your mother has fallen, and she thinks she's broken her leg. So that was pretty alarming, and so I made a few calls, and we finally got mom in a ambulance, and she was taken to Mariah Hospital. She's from down like SBZ, taken to Mariah Hospital, and diagnosed with a broken hip, and but when they brought her down, she was ill. You could tell that she was ill with was more going on than just a broken hip, and so we sort of waited and see what the doctors were going to say, and I talked to mom, and she got the hip fixed up with an operation, and I talked to her and realized that other things were going on, and more conversations were had, and then I had a conversation with the doctor, and the doctor had said that they had found what looked like to be cancer, and things progressed pretty quick from that diagnosis. So she was diagnosed with cancer, and finally she was given many tests, and each test that came back was worse news than the other. And she was finally diagnosed with a terminal cancer, and the timelines had changed a little bit on life expectancy, it was one hard conversation after another. In those conversations, if you've had someone in your family or a close friend that's been diagnosed with a terminal disease, it's difficult. As you feel for the person that you love, and also for yourself. And what the last 6 weeks were for me were very, very difficult. But what I witnessed with my dear mom was a was dignity that I had never seen before, and a grace in her darkest hour that I really couldn't understand. She never panicked. She never complained. She held her head high. She wanted to make sure I understood everything going on. When I went to visit her in Mariah Hospital, when finally things were diagnosed to be terminal, and she said, "I want you to talk to the doctor and hear what the doctor has to say." And I talked to the doctor, and she looked at me the whole time I was talking to the doctor, not just to see you know, if I was going to be okay, but she wanted to make sure that I understood. It's been a difficult 6 weeks, like anyone who's gone through that. And so my mom was a great mom. She was a great friend. She was with me, you know, from the start, and that bond was never broken. And you know, you just never think that this is going to happen, but when it does, it's certainly like a dart, you know, that hits you. I got down to see her a few times. I had gone down to see her and when she was originally diagnosed, and then I'd gone to see her when she was first taken into palliative care in Matapédia. And my third journey down, I was going down a third time to see her, knowing that things were pretty close to the end. And that was July 6th on Tuesday, and I got a call from Matapédia and from the palliative care unit in Matapédia, and I knew that wasn't a good call. And I was in Rimouski, about 3 hours out from getting to Matapédia, and the nurse said, "Where are you, Bobby?" And I knew that wasn't good. And I said I was in Rimouski, and she said, "Well, I don't think you're going to get there in time." And so I made a few calls to see if I can get someone up, because at the time there was no one with her. And I made a call, and we finally got someone on the road to go up and see her. And I called Matapédia back, and I called the nurse back, and said that there was someone on their way up. And the nurse said, "Well, unfortunately, she just passed away." I was stuck in traffic on the 132, and I was, you know, it was the longest and probably the loneliest 3 hours of my entire life, as I then finished the trip off to Matapédia, and that was it. That's the sort of the story. She was born in Florence. She was born to a beautiful family, the Dumbills, and Nanny and Puppy, and Colin and Jimmy, her two brothers, and Mary and Jean and Elaine, her three sisters. Just a beautiful family. A simple family that was brought up on a farm, and just the nicest people that you could ever meet. And I got a chance to talk a lot with Colin and with Jimmy, and I've got to see some family I hadn't seen in a long time before. So it's been a long 6 weeks, and you know, if anyone knew Mom, she was this simple girl without any huge talents or huge skills, or She didn't, but she was light. She when she came into a room, you knew she was there, and especially if she'd burst out into one of her laughs. And if anyone's knows Mom, then you'd know that laugh. That wouldn't necessarily come with a good joke. It would just come in conversation. And something would happen, and something triggered her in her mind, and a leg would kick, and the arms would fly, and she'd go back, and in this, I guess you could call it a laugh, but it was this hoop. And yeah, maybe we'll do a song, and I'll talk a little bit about more about Mom. I had all kinds of things to say. I had all kinds I lined up these things that I could say, and it's a show that I come on, and it's not a show that I really wanted to do, but I wanted to do a little something for her and remember her with our Facebook community, so that's why we're here. And she had five grandchildren, and Carter and Jackson out in Regina, my brother's two kids, and Noah and Jack, my two older boys, and Dylan, who she got to meet in Matapedia. Dylan got to come in and see her three times. It lit her up for a minute. It's bittersweet to take Dylan in to see her, with a few weeks to live. It was difficult, but I'm glad that we brought him. I'm glad that she saw him, and I'm glad that they at least made that connection here. Even though Dylan might not remember, we can say, Dylan, you met your grandmother, and so. That was nice. And here we go. We'll do a song. This song here, April had found, and I've never heard of it, and I hope I can remember it. And it's a song that's written about a mother who has died from a son, and that's why April had chosen it. And so I'm going to give it a shot, and hope I can get through it. I hope I can get through this show. It'll be what it's going to be. So, here is, I don't even know the name of this song, Heaven's Garden. I don't know who wrote it. Who wrote the song? Do we know that? So we're going to hit that little button, April, and we'll, sing a song. Tell me if heaven has a garden, and could you take my mama there? Walk her slowly to your flower bed, pick her roses for all the words unsaid. Kiss her gently upon her soft cheek, and carry her if her legs are weak. Please tell her I'm okay down here. Does she see me? Can she hear? I've heard heaven has a garden with angels singing on a cloudy bandstand. Up in heaven in that garden, won't you take my mama there by the hand? She left me with memories made of gold, Gentle love was a wonder to behold. Ask her to sing her favorite song. We down here are sing along. I've heard heaven has a garden with angels singing on a cloudy bandstand. Won't you take my mama there? Won't you take my mama by the hand? Won't you take my mama by the hand? Who wrote that song? Do we know?
I can find.
We weren't ready to do this show. We even got into a row before the show and left the mics on. Oh, well, that's my fault. I was just panicking because it was very emotional. April put a beautiful video together of my mom and it's... This is a tough one, but I'm glad whoever's out there. I've had the most beautiful messages. We put the show out yesterday afternoon, and the messages that have come back, hundreds and hundreds, and from different people that I hear from, some people that I don't know, some people that I haven't heard from in many, many years, it was emotional. I've tried to answer all of them, and if I haven't answered all of them, I will from all my heart. I appreciate the people that I know haven't seen my mom in years. It's pretty much the same sentiment. They know who she was, and for those of you who didn't get to see her in her final days and final weeks and final days, she was that person from all along. She was in Moriah Hospital, and I got to visit her there. In Moriah, just at the end of COVID, that it was kind of hard and difficult to get in and see her. But I did. I talked to the doctors and the nurses, and they all loved her. They all thought she was just this beautiful lady, and she never wavered from who she was. She couldn't be anything than who she was. And that person was with a heart of gold. And she went to Rimouski Hospital, and I was a little worried. She had to do a procedure when she went to Rimouski Hospital. You know, she doesn't know anyone in Rimouski. She doesn't speak a lot of French. I thought it was very French there. I talked to the staff in Rimouski, the two or three days that she was there, and I talked to them every day, and it was a beautiful experience. When Mom got back, she said, I just loved the doctors and the nurses. At Rimouski, a doctor sat down for a few hours with her on her bed and talked to her, and they talked to me, and it was beautiful. And God bless the staff and at Rimouski Hospital and Moriah Hospital and in Matapédi at the CLSC. God bless these hardworking doctors and nurses who have to do this every day. For me and my brother and family, it was very, very difficult, and I can't imagine that these people have chosen this as their life, as their careers, and it's a calling. So to all staff, to the three places that she was at, Rimouski and Moriah and Matapédi, I thank you from the bottom of my heart, and you treated my mother so well and with dignity, and it was really a pleasure to see you know, the staff, the staff of doctors and nurses and everyone else that works in the hospitals, that the compassion. And so I thank you very much. What's up? The chair's creaking. Are we gonna, do you wanna get into a row again? You left the mics on.
No, I didn't. There's something wrong with the board.
There's something wrong with the board?
Everything was muted, so I didn't know why that was. We apologize about that.
Turn your mic on and come on and say.
Well, they heard me earlier when I was muted, so I would think they could hear me.
I don't know what's going on.
I
then.
Know.
We we'll stayed up till 1 o'clock last night to try and get this right, and we don't. And then the world catches me in my panic and us in our world. Don't worry, world, though we love each other very much. This is a typical thing that can happen. This was a little bit more stressful than usual. Just you try to get something right and it goes wrong. But Mom never liked Facebook, so maybe she really she thought that
talking too much either.
She didn't like us talking too much. She didn't like me talking too much, which I tend to do, and I ramble on. And anyways, you know. That's getting caught with the mic on. And, but that's, you know, it is what it is. But, okay. So, but now April and I have got to join our spirits up together. And, so apparently this next song, Seven Spanish Angels, I've heard it by Ray Charles and, Willie Nelson, but, I guess this was, I did not know that this was one of her favorite songs, but I've been told that it's been one of her favorite songs. So we're going to give it a shot. I hadn't played this song until yesterday, maybe. How does this song go, April? Can you give me the, how does this one go? I need to lie down. We good?
Yeah, just the ad.
You got the ad going? I just need to hear the air of it, that's all. How does the world see, hear everything that we're talking about if the mics are all?
It's crazy.
All right, we're good. Are you ready?
I guess so.
Hit that little piton, that little button. We're good. Here we go. April's gonna help me sing this one. He looked down into her brown eyes and said, "Say a prayer for me." She threw her arms around him, whispered, "God will keep us free." They could see the riders coming, said, "This is my last fight. If they take me back to Texas, they won't take me back alive." There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. They were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home. She reached down and picked the gun up that lay smoking in his hand. She said, "Father, please forgive me. Can't make it without my man." And she knew the gun was empty, and she knew she could not win. But a final prayer was answered when the rifles fired again. And there were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. And they were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home. They came and found the lovers as they lay there side by side. The dreams had all been shattered. They said she was his bride. And they laid them by the altar in the valley of the gun. Now the final fight was over and the battle had been won. There were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. And they were praying for the lovers in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home. Just move it up. Do the chorus one more time. You ready? And there were seven Spanish angels at the altar of the sun. And they were praying for the lover in the valley of the gun. When the battle stopped and the smoke cleared, there was thunder from the throne. And seven Spanish angels took another angel home. Seven Spanish angels. I don't know who wrote that song. I know the third verse that we did in that song is written by someone else other than who wrote the original version of that song. Anyways, that was Seven Spanish Angels. So I think right now April has put a video together and a tribute to my lovely mom, to Elizabeth Ann Dumville. She used to call herself the Queen. And to some of my cousins, they would know her as the Queen. And she would joke with that. And the Queen is coming. And so I don't know if I can watch this or not. I don't know if I can see it or not, actually. But we'll play it for you. I've seen a little bit of it a while ago, and I had to turn my head. But it's some pictures of mom. Mom didn't like pictures. She never liked pictures. Even great pictures of her, she just didn't like to be in pictures. But so there was even jokes around, should we even put pictures, because mom didn't like them. She really didn't like them. But it's like, you know what? Sorry, mom. Too bad. But we're gonna show your beauty and show your beautiful face, and we're gonna do a tribute. And April, are we ready for the tribute?
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars. I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on a cross, my burdens gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great.
FX off. All right, that was beautiful. That was that tribute was put together by April, and April, because of COVID, never got a chance to meet Mom until until we went down a few weeks ago, and we got to see Mom, April, and I, and Dylan, and my cousin Kareen had come down, and the four of us had gone down, and I would say one of the longest drives I've ever taken from Montreal to the Gaspé Coast with Dylan. April sat in the back seat, and baby sat Dylan, and now April's gone off to do something again. If anyone knows April at all, when she got back, she would be talking to some of her sisters about meeting my mom, and talking to friends or just in general, and she'd say, not about Dylan meeting mom or anything going on, but she'd say, you know what, your mom said she really really liked me, and that I thought was pretty cute, as she would say, yeah. And mom did, and of course mom knew she would, they talk on the phone, and they were communicating before this, but she had never met mom, and so that was the bittersweet day of introducing mom finally to my lovely and beautiful partner and Dylan. And April and most people that visit her would tell you the same thing, this dignity that she had, this beauty that was there in this ill lady, frail body, but it was a sort of a final lesson I think to my brother and I. It really seemed like a lesson, even in the darkest times when there's that much uncertainty about what's going to happen, mom showed bravery and dignity and grace, and so I just wanted to take a moment now just sort of as her son, and we're going to sing a final song and be out of here. But what mom meant to me, we were always close, I would say, very close for a son and a mother, and like a lot. I'm sure there's a lot of sons closer to their moms, and I certainly, I've had my struggles in my life, and some of you know about those struggles, and struggles with addictions and alcoholism, and she wasn't happy with sometimes. She said to me from the hospital bed, she looked at me straight in the eyes and said, well, we've had our ups and downs, to me. And I said, well, mom, you were the ups and I was the downs. If there were ups and downs, it was never caused by her. That's for sure. But she was always there. Nearly 4 years ago, when I had made a decision to really try and change my life, she had waited. She had waited and she had waited for me to do so. When she finally realized that a change was going on, that I was trying something very different, and when there was nothing else, when I had lost everything, I'd lost everything, she was there, and she had waited. And then when she had seen that change could happen, and she just encouraged me, and she came in, and November 8th, 2017, I made a very big decision to change my life. And from November 8th, 2017, which is a date that's very special to me and a date that was very special to her, we talked almost every night on the phone. I check in with her, and around 9 o'clock and 10 o'clock, and she was so encouraging, and she just believed that that change was possible for me and for everyone, and she always believed that. And I'd found a note when I was cleaning up the house back home, my childhood home, Derek's, and where Mom lived most of her life. I'd found a note, one of the final notes I'd found in her purse. When I picked her stuff up from Matapedia after she had passed away. And on that note, the note was someone's number and a few other things scribbled on the note. But below that was change is possible, and everyone can change their life and start anew and build again. And she believed that of me, and she believed that of everyone. And if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't have made the changes that I did. I really believe that she made those. She helped me make those changes, and she encouraged me to do so with love and devotion. I thank her, with infinite love and eternal love for my mom, my dear mom. And she'll never be forgotten in my heart. She'll never go away from my memories, I loved her so dearly. I can feel her, she's okay. And I believe that. And if there was a promise that I would make to my mom, she was there to help me along and move along. I'm just going to try harder every day to be a better person, to try to achieve something near what my mother was all her life, what she was natural at. I will do my best to be a good partner and a good father and a decent human being, and I have lots to look up to with my mom. So I could talk for a long time about what she means, she means the world to me, she's not gone, and she'll never be forgotten. So here we go. We're gonna sing one final song. Amazing grace, how sweet that sound, that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieve. And how precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, we have already come. And 'twas grace hath brought us safe thus far, and grace will lead us home. We've been there 10,000 years, and bright shining as the sun. And we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. April, come and join me.
Amazing grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet that sound, that saved a wretch like me. Well, I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. We'll do it one more time. Ready? Amazing grace, how sweet that sound, that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. I was blind, but now I see. Of course, that's Amazing Grace. Did you sing on that one, April?
No, I'm muted.
You're muted.
I'm still muted.
Okay.
I don't want
to. It's harder
that.
To hear
that's
you. That's
beautiful.
Why I couldn't hear you singing, because you were muted. But yeah, that's it. Anyways, I want to thank just finish off by thanking everyone for their very very kind. Sentiments and condolences that we've gotten on Facebook, hundreds and hundreds, and it's been uplifting to see that love for my mom and for Elizabeth Ann Dumville, and I want to thank her friends. She was blessed to have some very very good friends. Some beautiful friends, and that were there until the end with her, that visited her, that gave comfort to my brother and I, Derek, who lives in Regina, and I'm in Ottawa, and we couldn't be there, we just knew that she was always in good company, and so to her friends. Down in Florence Point and Miguasha and in other places, to her sweet friend Joan, who I got to talk to many times, who helped me and through this, and to many 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 friends, and it's
not many people that I've known that have this just a lot of friends with a lot of love from different cliques and from different places. Mom didn't belong to a clique. She belonged to a lot of cliques, and she fit in everywhere she was and everywhere she went. And to that beautiful wacky laugh that I'll remember forever, and I'll remember my mom dearly forever and ever and ever. And I love you, Mom, from the bottom of my heart, like I've told you many times. And I'll tell you again, and I'll tell you over and over. And, you know, look after me, look after us, look after my brother, look after the grandchildren, and look down upon us. Make sure we're doing right, make sure we're doing good, and never to be forgotten. So, do you have anything else, April, for the show, or we're good? So, we're going to be having a service for Mom later on this summer in a few weeks, and I look forward to seeing some family that I haven't seen in a long time, and I wish it was under different circumstances, but still, if it has to be under these circumstances, I know it's a beautiful family. I've said it over and over again, but the Dumbbells, just beautiful people. And for all your help during these times, for all your love, I thank you. And that's it. That's all I got tonight. So we're gonna bid you farewell. And I think we'll be coming back more regular with our regular shows. As the show must go on, and Mom wouldn't want it any other way. Mom would want us to go on and live life and to its utmost, and that's what I plan to do. So and that's what we plan to do. So we'll be back with more shows, probably even next Sunday. So that's it. Thanks for coming along, and thanks for all your love and all your support, and for all the condolences and the messages we've received. Thank you very much, and we'll see you soon. So until then, peace and love.